In this video, I want to make a crucible that can withstand high temperature to melt gold.
Always handle chemical with safety and in ventilated area, and be careful while working with fire. Materials needed: 50 grams of aluminum oxide and 35 grams of clay.
I added 50 grams of aluminum oxide to the dish, and now I wanna weigh clay, 35 grams of clay. Afterward, I add powder to the ball mill to mix them thoroughly and crush any possible coarse particles. Then I add steel balls to the ball mill tank to fill about one-third of capacity of tank. Next, it's time to put the cap on and machine is ready to run. After assembling the machine, I run it for 45 minutes. We don't want machine to run very fast, but we need adequate speed which balls fall inside the tank wall that friction between them green powder as much as possible. It seems 45 minutes was enough. Let's see what's happening inside the tank. The powder seems very fine and homogeneous. Before adding water to the powder to make a paste, I just add a little bit of sodium silicate glue or water glass to the water. Add water slowly to the powder to make paste. Be careful to not add much water. Afterwards, mix them to achieve a good consistency to handle. This is our mold. I made it from an aluminum pipe of 5 cm diameter with a cut at the side. An iron ball to give a convex shape to the crucible. First, we grease the mold with petroleum jelly and then press some of the paste in the mold with ball. And remove paste residue. Try to remove ball without any damaging to the crucible. Give it a clean polished shape with your finger that is wet. I tape the mold to prevent expanding and growing cracks from the gap. It's time to leave the crucible to the dryness while covering it with a wet tissue and a plastic bag. This promotes crucible dry slowly while preventing cracking. After 24 hours and little hardening, mold has been removed. Because mold prevents our crucible to be dry uniformly and cause growing cracks. You may notice reducing in the size, but it's okay. It takes about 1 week for crucible to dry completely. Afterwards, we should place it in the oven with a temperature of 85 degrees Celsius for 8 hours to remove any trace of water remaining. I use lab oven, but you can use a kitchen oven instead. Crucible should be dried as much as possible before putting in the oven. Next, we should hydrate crucible with oxyfuel or propane air torch. In case of oxyfuel torch, I start with preheating and then with reducing flame. It needs to be heated from all sides uniformly. And next, natural flame to get red hot. And glazing crucible with borax. I cover crucible with something thick-walled to cool down slowly. Our crucible is ready for melting down some gold. Gold powder added and wetted with water mist. And some sodium carbonate and borax. To get purer gold, we can add potassium nitrate occasionally. Gold has been melted and its final result. Crucible is okay and can withstand high temperature without getting ruined. Look at that nice glassy glaze. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to get new video updates. Thanks for watching.